How you going, everyone? I just wanted to talk about these new MB31s. Just arrived here in Australia that I bought. And yeah, I'm actually quite impressed with these cells, the looks of them so far. Especially for the price you can get them for now. I just got these not long ago. And I was originally running these older Winston cells, but now I'm looking at experimenting with these and see what these are like. Running on a JK inverter BMS for a shunt, Victron shunt. I run all Victron gear, so, and servo as well, and Phoenix, and the old one that's actually old 150-85, which is actually running these carbon lead cells with the JK, just a straight 5 amp balancer, which works really well on older type cells like lead cells of all different types, instead of just letting them try and balance themselves with equalization. That thing there works really well, just a straight 5 amp balancer. Anyway, back to these. Bought these a little while ago and had a chance to sort of set them up. Initial look of it, like most people worry about bulging and all this sort of stuff. These things are like dead flat. Like, straight as a rule pretty well, so. Probably have never been used, I'd say, because they're sold as A-grade cells, and yeah, I'm thinking they're A-grade. Going off the barcodes, I checked and they're only a couple months old, so quite happy with that. Initial tests I did, pretty well all of them come at the same voltage, except for one was 0.1 volt difference, which was the second one here, and they're all 0.18 mega ohms in the resistance test, which is pretty well perfect. Can't really get any better than that, considering they would have had to come through shipping and everything like that, so really, really good. So I'm going to be giving these an experiment for the upcoming videos that I'm going to show soon with some other things, and sort of compare them to the older Winstons and the advantages of sort of getting these new cells for what they cost now, which is, you know, unheard of like 10 years ago. Been doing solars for like solar systems for the last 15 years, not mainly off grid, more on grid stuff, but in this place here I run everything off grid because I'm at least a kilometer from the power line, so I have to solely rely on it, so there's no backup from the grid at all. So got to get everything right, because if I'm away for a little bit of time, got to make sure these things work perfectly, otherwise fridges go out and you lose food and all that sort of stuff. So, but yeah, so far these look like really promising batteries to get into, especially being 300 amps per cell. So if you're off grid and you're looking at buying into something, I'm sort of thinking I'd recommend these sort of things these days compared to the old big cells, which cost a fortune and are so heavy. Like that little pack there's half the capacity of all these big giant cells, so that's the technology difference these days, and just the capacity, usable capacity, and so much better. Especially experimenting with these, and these are quite old now, they still real good performers. So I will do some more videos upcoming about this system and comparing it to this and these systems and how they all hook to the servo and how to connect them all up. So at the moment this is my first initial charge of these. They've probably got about 400 to 500 watts going into them at the moment, because I actually run two separate panel arrays on the roof. One half is going into this and the other half is going down into this one here. But I haven't got the inverter hooked up to this at the moment, it's just in charge mode. But so far, even under charge, well, this is charging at the moment, and there's like 0.1, 0.2 of a cell deviation over all of them. So that's pretty promising to show that they're pretty balanced straight off the bat. So I'm pretty well knowing that these are definitely A-grade cells and not some cheaper B-grade cells like most people are buying off the market these days off like Alibaba and AliExpress and stuff like that. So you got to know where to buy them. Well, actually, I bought these ones from a person in Australia, and I highly recommend him. Just get my password to open my computer. So there's this website here, which is his. So he is Lifo4 Australia, or on the lifo4.com.au. I looked around the internet, found that he's got the best prices, and by the time you try and import stuff from Alibaba and muck around with all that money exchanging through all their systems and not knowing who you're really dealing with, it was really good to buy through this fella. Highly recommend Mark. He's down at Harvey Bay. Really good guy. Look into him if you're going to buy LFO4 batteries. And yeah, he's really good to deal with, and his prices are actually really comparable too. So anyway, that's what I recommend buying through after doing a fair bit of study. But yeah, overall I reckon these things are going to be the new king of cells when it comes to off-grid stuff, and more people are going to be buying into them now because of the price. So anyway, I've got more videos that I'll do later about all the different systems, different comparisons between different cells. Now that I've got these, I'll be able to do some tests. Gonna do some more comparisons with these carbon lead cells compared to these, and AGM deep cycle cells, just their different characteristics and what sort of performance you're going to get. And plus, they're saying you're going to get, you know, 8,000 to 10,000 cycles out of these newer type cells. So it's pretty promising, consider these ones are an older type technology, and they're 8 years old, I think, 7 or 8 years old, and they've still got really high capacity. So really promising for like off-gridders in the future, I reckon. Anyway, I'll see you in the next videos later on. Cheers.